different pieces. It's a D, E, and F. D, E, and F. Have you clicked? Okay, right. So they say show that triangle D, E, F is actually right angle.
Triangle.
Okay, so what makes right angle triangle right angle?
90 degrees.
But too bad that day in the exam you don't have the tractor.
Right.
You cannot measure, and if they don't provide you with graph paper, so you can't really draw it accurately and measure. So how are you gonna prove that they are actually that this is right angle triangle?
Hypotenuse.
Trigo, yes.
Sine, cosine, and
Pythagoras. Okay, but you guys haven't learned yet, so yes, Pythagoras
theorem.
Okay?
Yeah.
So,
Trigo.
Sounds like
Trigo.
Trigo
is nice.
Trigo.
Wow.
Trigo.
Wow.
This is that smart Trigo, guys.
Advertisement.
Pythagoras theorem. So for every coordinate geometry, if you think it's wow, I can't really see it, so please sketch it. So 6-1, you just need to estimate 6-1 maybe around here. Jeffrey, listen first, later you continue at home. Okay, and then E is 2-3, maybe somewhere around here. F is maybe here. You see, I just estimate. So I'm gonna get this triangle. Okay. Doesn't look like right angle triangle at the moment, but
you gotta turn your head upside down.
No.
Okay, so let's say I tell you this is 3 units long from E to F, and E to D is 4 units long. F to D is let's say 5 units long. Okay? So let's see whether it fits to Pythagoras theorem.
Yes.
It's your A squared plus B squared equals
of
to
course.
C squared. You guys are so familiar with this. But I hope you know C is always the longest side. Which one is the longest side?
Hypotenuse.
Which is the 5. So let's see whether it fits. 3 squared is
9.
4 squared is
16.
5 squared is 9 plus 16 is
25.
So does it fit?
Yeah.
Oh,
so if it fits, meaning it's a right angle?
Triangle.
But let's say if I change this into 7, do you think it will fit?
No.
No.
So can I say that this is right angle triangle?
No.
No.
No, right? So therefore, our goal is actually to find out how long actually is EF, how long is actually ED, and how long is actually FD. Then after that, we put them inside a Pythagoras theorem, see whether it fits. That's how you show that this is right. No, no, it's not going to be so long. Okay, now let's find...
You have to find ED F. And EF.
Okay, let's say I want to find EF. Now, let's say J. Sub the number for me, please. EF. I want E and F. Oh, okay. If you need that, I'll write here. E is 2, 3. F is negative 1, negative 3. Which one you want it to be? X1, Y1, X2, Y2.
X1.
This one.
Yeah.
X1, Y1, X2,
tricky.
Y2. Alright, so sub. 2.
Minus.
2.
Negative
1. Yes, thank you. And then the other one?
2.
Yeah, I really like the way Jane do it. She knows she's gonna get confused, so she label it first. It's okay just to go at another one. But rather than you get it wrong later, yeah? So now evaluate this for me. Pavitra, 2 minus negative 1, what do you get? 3, yes, 3 squared. Ruby, 3 minus negative 3.
9.
3 minus negative 3, 6, yes, 6 squared. So let's do a little bit of quick math here. Fionn?
Yeah, quick math is 2 plus 2,
2 plus 2 is 4. Minus 1 plus 3, quick math.
3 squared is 9, 6 squared is
36.
So 36 plus 9,
45.
Right, so now, just leave your answer like that. You don't have to press it into calculator because at the end of the day, I want to sub it into a squared plus b squared equals to
c squared.
You're going to square it anyway, right? So just leave it like that. Now, can you help me pause for a while? Right. So now that let's check whether they fit into Pythagoras' theorem.
It's 25.
This one?
Yeah.
No, it's 20, correct? It's correct. Right, so let's take a look. So let's plug it in. FE is actually square root 25. ED is square root 20. And then FB is square root 65. Tell me which one is the longest side here, Robson. Which one is the longest side?
Yeah,
this one is the longest side. So this must be my C squared. So let's put inside the Pythagoras theorem. So A squared plus B squared goes to C squared, right? So this one is the shorter one. See whether they are actually true. Pavitra, square of square root 45. What is square root 45 times square root 45? Square 45 times square 45. How do you get rid of a square root usually? You square, right? So do you still see any more square root here? So it's yes? 45. This one is the square root will still be there? No. 20. This one? Square root 65 times square root 65. Can press your calculator if you want. Yeah, it won't be there anymore. So you get 65. Is it the same?
Yes.
So it fits Pythagoras' theorem. So it is shown that it is right angle triangle.